So let us quickly begin with the fifth chapter, where we are talking about the natural vegetation. As you're all aware, we will be talking about the evergreen forest, deciduous forest. We will be talking about the deserts, mountain forests, coastal swamps. So let's see one after the other, right? To begin with, we have to consider these five, that is tropical, evergreen and semi-evergreen forests. So let us see what are all the different things that are usually present in the tropical, evergreen and semi-evergreen forests. First important thing, western slope of Western Ghats. Windward side of Western Ghats will receive heavy rainfall. Hills in the northeastern region and Andaman and Nicobar Islands also receive heavy rainfall. They are found in warm and humid areas with an annual precipitation of over 200 cm and the mean annual temperature about 22 degrees Celsius. That is, the temperature is hot and rainfall is above 200, we call it hot and wet, evergreen type of forest. Tropical evergreen forests are well stratified, that is layer after layers will be usually present, with layers closer to the ground are covered with shrubs and creepers, with short structured trees followed by tall variety of trees. In these forests, trees reach great heights up to 60 meter or above. There is no definite time for trees to shed their leaves, and flowering, fruition, everything happens throughout the year. So we call it evergreen. As such, these forests appear green all round the year. Some of the most important trees are rosewood, mahogany, ebony. UPSC usually will ask you this question. One additional example is ebony. The semi-evergreen forests are found. So if you have evergreen here, just beside that you will have semi-evergreen forests are found in the less rainy parts of this region. That is western side of Western Ghats, extreme western side, you get evergreen, and beside that you get semi-evergreen. Such forests have a mixture of evergreen and moist deciduous forests. So you will have both evergreen and deciduous. Deciduous means they will not receive rainfall in some time. That is usually in winter or summer they may not receive rainfall. At that time, usually the leaves may shed. The undergrowing climbers give an evergreen character to these forests. So that's why it is called a semi-evergreen forest. So can you observe? This is usually present in the Western Ghats, and it is also present in Tamil Nadu as it receives rainfall. Andaman and Nicobar and Lakshadweep also receives this, and most importantly, the Northeast India receives heavy rainfall. The British were aware of the economic values of these forests, hence large-scale exploitation of these forests were started. And the oak forests in Garhwal and Kumaun were replaced by pine chairs, which were needed to lay railway lines. Very, very important. What is usually used to lay railway lines? It is chir pine. Forests were also cleared for introducing tea plantations, rubber, coffee. The British also used timber for construction activities, as it acts as an insulator of heat. Very, very important for us to look at the commercial aspect or use of this particular forest. And then you need to know about the tropical deciduous forest, which varies from 70 to 200 centimeter. Deciduous means it will have one dry season. Now, the deciduous forest can be divided into wet deciduous forest, moist deciduous forest, and you also have dry deciduous forest. All this is very, very important. And now when we are talking about the moist deciduous forest, they are present throughout India and they vary from 100 to 200 centimeter. They start from the northeastern slopes along the foothills of Himalayas. Throughout you can see them. Eastern slopes of Western Ghats and Odisha. Also you can usually see this. Mainly they receive rainfall from cyclones also. Teak, Sal, Shisham, Hurra, Mahua, Amla, Semul, Kusum, Sandalwood are some of the major trees present. Then we need to talk about the dry deciduous forest, and usually they are present in the rainier parts of peninsula. Yeah, and the plains of UP and Bihar, usually dry deciduous forest is present. Have you, do you remember CWG we were talking? Usually in winter, Gangetic plains do not receive rainfall. It is this particular region where you usually observe dry deciduous forest, right? The leaves, tendus, palas, amaltas, bell, kher, axelwood is usually grown in this particular area. Tropical thorn forest, when we say, we talk about Punjab, Haryana, northwestern side, Rajasthan, Gujarat, Madhya Pradesh and Uttar Pradesh. Very, very important for us. Mountain forests, again, these are actually on the basis of height. If they are present in the tropical region with increasing altitude, we find different types of trees. And if it is present in the Himalayas, then what you see is usually different. The Himalayan ranges show a succession of vegetation from the tropical. At the bottom, you will find tropical. So, if I do this, tropical, temperate, and then you get polar. So, with increasing height, you usually find different vegetation being present. Deciduous forests are found in the foothills of the Himalayas. It is succeeded by wet temperate type of forest with an altitude of 1000 to 2000. Wet temperate, where rainfall will be bit more. In higher hill ranges, especially of northeast India, hilly areas of West Bengal and Uttaranchal, evergreen broad-leaved forest is usually present. Whereas, if you actually see other places, pine, chir pine is used for chemical, Chir pine is used for commercial purposes. Deodar, a highly valued endemic species, grows mainly in the western part of the Himalayan range. Deodar is a durable wood mainly used in construction activity. Similarly, chinar, walnut, Kashmir handicrafts usually belong to this particular zone. So, you need to know about the tribes Gujjars, Bakarwals, Bhotias, Gaddis, who are very, very essential for us to understand, right? The southern slopes of the Himalayas carry a thicker vegetation cover because of relatively higher precipitation than the drier north-facing slopes. At higher altitudes, mosses and lichens form part of the tundra vegetation. No need to remember, guys. If you can actually go through this carefully, it's enough. We need to talk about the mountain forests. One is in the Himalayas, the other one in the southern mountain forest. Here we are talking about Western Ghats, Vindhyas and Nilgiris. And here you usually see temperate forests with greater heights called as Sholas in the Nilgiris, Annamalai and Palani Hills. No need to remember much. If you can go through this carefully, it is more than enough. Littoral and swamp forests, usually in the deltas, you find some sort of mangrove forest. We call it littoral and swamp forest. Chilka Lake, Kalidio National Park or Bharatpur, and they are also called as wetlands, right? The country's wetlands are present in different parts. Lakes they have given. No need to remember. You will be seeing them properly in environment and ecology. Don't rely on this for environment and ecology much, because most of it has actually changed. Now, when they talk about the forest cover of India, you should be aware that in India, mostly you find moist deciduous forest. And this question was asked in UPSC. Moist deciduous forest is present in India, right? So, this is also very, very important. And then you need to talk about the forest conservation policy, not properly given, not updated. Please try to see environment and ecology for this. Social forestry is where we say the community's role in actually improving the forest cover. And there you have to talk about urban forestry in urban areas, rural forestry and farm forestry, where trees will be grown in the farm, so which has commercial use. Right? Commercial green belts you usually observe. farm forestry, can you see commercial purpose and non-commercial purpose? If you have a land, usually you grow trees on all these sites to ensure that whatever is there in this region is usually not affected much. Forest departments of various states distribute seedlings of trees free of cost to these farmers to ensure that in their land they usually grow this, and it usually acts as a protective layer for soil as well. Right guys, so all this is important. Again, wildlife not very very important. You need to understand the zones and all, wildlife conservation of India, biosphere, all this. Again, list of biosphere reserves is not important from this. My suggestion to you, please see environment and ecology separately for this particular chapter. As the first important portions you have to see, others not so important. Right guys, again I have told you, even in 9th standard NCERT book, the information given with respect to environment and ecology is not worth. Only whenever definitions are there, we will look into those definitions. But this is already available and it is updated where new things are also being present. Please try to read it in your environment and ecology classes as well. They have given certain biosphere reserves, that is the Nilgiri biosphere reserve is given and also Sundarban is given, right? So it's very very important for you to complete this particular reserve. Please guys, go through this carefully from environment and ecology point of view. Don't waste your time in reading these. Once if you read these three reserves, there is no harm. But still, I would say read in detail with respect to environment and ecology. Else, there is nothing much to see in this particular